Welcome to lecture 6 on measure and integration. If you recall, in the previous lecture we had started looking at various properties of the length function. In today's lecture we'll continue looking at the properties of the length function, and then we'll try to characterize some other countably additive set functions on the class of all intervals in the real line. So, the first topic we will continue is the length function and its properties, and then countably additive set functions on algebras. Let us just recall what are the properties of the length function that we have already proved. So, length function was defined on the class of all intervals, that is I, and to every interval with end points left end point A and right end point B, or need not be left and right. Normally, we will write the left end point A first and right end point B later. So, for an interval with end points A and B, its length lambda of I we defined as the absolute value of B minus A, if A and B are real numbers, and in case either of it is plus infinity or minus infinity, we will define the length to be equal to infinite. So, for all finite intervals, the length is the usual concept of the difference between the values of the endpoints. So, that is absolute value of B minus A and the plus infinity if the interval is infinite. So, we proved the properties that the length of the empty set, and that is the interval, is 0. Then we proved the monotone property of the length function, namely length of I is less than length of j if I is an interval which is inside the interval j. And then we proved finite additivity property, namely if an interval I can be written as a finite disjoint union of intervals j I equal to 1 to n, then the length of the interval I is same as summation of lengths of the individual intervals. So, if I is a finite disjoint union of intervals, the length of I is summation length of j i's. And then we looked at a slight extension of this property, namely if I is a finite or a infinite interval, actually we looked at that, and it is contained in a union of intervals I i's, that is I is covered by a finite union of intervals which need not be disjoint, then length of I is less than or equal to summation length of the intervals I i's 1 to n, the finite number of them. And then so this was called for the finite I is covered by a finite union, and now then we extended this property to the arbitrary countable union. So, if I is an interval which is covered by a countable union of intervals I which need not be disjoint, then we proved that lambda of I is less than or equal to summation of length of the individual intervals. And if you recall, this property use what is called the Hein-Borel property on real line. Let us continue our study. So, next thing we want to prove is the following, that if I is a interval which is a interval which is a finite interval, say, and it is a union of intervals I n's n equal to pairwise disjoint intervals, then the length of I is equal to sigma length of I n's. This property, in fact, we had proved it. So, let us prove it once again. So, let us look at this property. So, if I is an interval which is written as a union of intervals I n's n equal to 1 to infinity, I is finite. So, keep in mind we are keeping I as a finite interval, and I n intersection I m is equal to empty, then that implies length of I is equal to sigma length of I n's 1 to infinity. So, recall we have already shown that length of I is less than or equal to sigma length of I n's. That is because of the property that just now proved, I is covered by a union of intervals. So, length of I must be less than or equal to. To prove the other way around, so to show length of I is bigger than or equal to sigma I equal to 1 to infinity length of I is. This is what is to be shown. So, let us note that for any n I 1 up to I n, these are the intervals which are contained in I, right? And I is finite. So, let us say this is the interval with endpoints A and B, that is I, and A 1 I 1 is an interval which is inside A B. So, it has endpoints say A 1 B 1, I 2 has endpoints A 2 B 2, and I n has endpoints A n B n. But these being finite numbers and they are disjoint, so we can arrange the intervals like A 1 here, B 1 here, maybe A 2 here, B 2 here, and so on, and A n here and B n here. So, what we are saying is, we can assume, so without the loss of generality, we can say that A is less than or equal to A 1, is less than B 1, less than or equal to A 2, less than A 2, less than, strictly less than B 2, and less than or equal to, and so on, and less than or equal to B n, less than or equal to B. And once that property is true, we can so immediate that B minus A is bigger than or equal to B n minus A 1, which is bigger than or equal to, now we can add and subtract consecutive terms. So, B n minus A n plus B n minus 1 minus A n minus 1 and so on plus B 1 minus A 1. So, add and subtract terms which are subtract a bigger term, add a smaller term, and so on. So, which is equal to sigma I equal to 1 to n length of i's, and this B minus A is length of I. So, what we have gotten is, this is for true for every n. So, that implies length of I, no sorry, this is bigger than or equal to, so this is bigger than or equal to sigma I equal to 1 to infinity length of I equal to 1 to infinity. So, that proves the other way round inequality also. So, hence what we have shown is that the length function has the property whenever a finite interval is written as, whenever a finite interval is written as a union, a countable union of disjoint intervals, then the length of the interval I is equal to summation of the lengths of the individual intervals. We would like to extend this property to not only to finite interval, in fact to any interval. So, for that we need a result, namely, suppose I is a any interval, then we want to claim that the length of I is equal to summation length of I intersection the interval n to n plus 1. Actually, we should So, this is the property we would like to prove, and in fact one can have here the interval which is left open n and right close n plus 1, because the end point is not going to matter. So, we want to prove that the length of an interval I is same as lengths of its species which lie inside the intervals n to n plus 1. So, to prove this property, let us observe the following. So, let us observe, this is a real line. So, we can write it as the intervals. So, here it is say 0, 1, 2 and so on, and here is on the other side. So, here is minus 1, minus 2 and so on. So, let us take an interval I. So, if possibly if I is finite, if it is a finite interval, then obviously it will lie between two some bounds. So, in finite, then there exists some n and m such that I is inside n to m, right. So, there will be some, so here is some n and here is some m, so that I is inside this, right. Now, let us look at the pieces. So, let us inside, let us look at the pieces of, so this is n plus I and this is n plus I plus 1. So, intersection with this I. So, what we are saying is this I can be written as union, a union of n to n plus I, I equal to, so 1 to up to up to n plus I equal to m, so that up to I equal to n plus I equal to m minus n, right. And now let us observe that these pieces, these are disjoint union. This union is a disjoint union and a finite number of them. So, this will imply length of I is equal to summation I equal to 1 to m minus n, length of n, n plus I. Now, this interval I does not intersect with any other interval out big, which is bigger than m and which is less than n. So, all those intervals, this is in the intersection with I is empty. So, what I can write is, this is same as sigma of I equal to 1 to m minus n. This is the intersection of, should have written the intersection with the interval I. So, the piece is, because the interval may start somewhere here. So, let us write this is intersection with the interval I. So, let me write this again. So, this is intersection with I. Okay. So, let us write this again. So, the I is written. So, I can be written as a union n to n plus from, sorry, this is also not wrong. Let me just write n to I can be written as union n plus I to n plus I plus 1 intersection I equal to, it starts with n, so 0 and goes up to when n plus I plus 1 is equal to, so that is m minus, so we want n plus, this is equal to m, so m minus n minus 1. Okay. So, that implies length of I, because this is a finite disjoint union, so this is equal to summation I equal to 0 to m minus n minus 1, length of n plus I to n plus I plus 1 intersection I. And now, for other parts they can be 0. So, I can write as sigma over I belonging to integers, length of n plus I, n plus I plus 1 intersection I over all I integers, all integers I, because the intersection with the other intervals is going to be empty and that is going to be 0. So, this proves that whenever I is finite, we are through. Okay. So, I finite case is okay. Now, let us prove the same thing when I is infinite. So, let us take I infinite. Then I can write I is equal to union of same thing n to n plus 1 intersection I belonging to integers, right. This is because, keeping in mind that the real line is equal to union n to n plus 1 n belonging to integers. Okay. So, interval I is this intersection this. And now, because I is infinite, let us say it looks like, say, something like a to plus infinity. So, in that case, this intersection of, so I infinite implies that n to n plus 1 intersection I is equal to n to n plus 1 for infinite n's. In fact, some stage onwards, so in fact, if n is say bigger than or equal to a, then that is the interval. So, here is a and here is n, then n to n plus 1 and so on, they are all going to be non-empty intersections with intersection being equal to that n plus 1. So, this implies that sigma length of n to n plus 1 intersection I is going to be equal to plus infinity, right, over all n belonging to Z. And that is same as length of I, because I is a infinite interval. So, that proves the property, namely, so this proves the property, namely, for any interval I, if for any interval I, the length of the interval can be written as the length of its pieces, lengths of the pieces I intersection n to n plus 1. So, this is an important property. So, it says length of any interval is a summation of lengths of its pieces. This property, and note that length of each one of these pieces being a finite interval is a finite number. So, we have this says that any interval can be written as a countable disjoint union of intervals, each having finite length. So, this is an important property which is going to be called as sigma finiteness property of the real numbers of the length function. So, let us, we are going to use this property to prove what is called countable additive property of the length function, and that says that the length function, if a interval I is written as a countable disjoint union of intervals I n's, then the length of the interval I is equal to summation length of I n's. So, to prove this property, so let us start looking at the proof of this property. So, to prove this property, let us write. So, I is a interval, okay. I is a interval which is written as a union of I n's, n equal to 1 to infinity, where the intervals I n intersection I m is equal to empty. To show that length of I is equal to summation length of I n's, n equal to 1 to infinity. So, let us look at a proof of this. Case 1, so assume, so let I be finite. Actually, finite or infinite is not important. So, let us take the general case itself. So, note I, length of I is equal to summation length of I intersection n to n plus 1, and this is because of the property that we have just now proved. And now also note, and I intersection n to n plus 1 can be written as, this is a finite interval, okay, and I is equal to, so this is n to n plus 1 intersection, this interval I is a countable disjoint union. So, it is a union of I j, j equal to 1 to infinity. So, we can write this as union j equal to 1 to infinity of I j intersection n to n plus 1. And now, this is a equality for finite intervals only, because I intersection n plus n to n plus 1 is a finite interval, which is written as a, because I j's are disjoint. So, these intervals are disjoint and they are finite. So, thus this implies by the additive property for finite intervals, which are disjoint, that lambda of I intersection n to n plus 1 is equal to summation j equal to 1 to infinity lambda of I j intersection n to n plus 1. right? So that here we are using the fact that whenever a interval I is a finite interval which is a countable disjoint union of intervals 1 to infinity, then the length of I is equal to summation of length of this. Now look at this equation here and look at this equation here. So length of I is equal to summation n over integers length of I intersection n to n plus 1, and that is computed to be equal to this. So combining these two, we get the property that length of I is equal to, which is summation n belonging to z of length of I intersection n to n plus 1, and that property we are going to put it here. So summation j equal to 1 to infinity lambda of I j intersection n to n plus 1. And now keep in mind that all this is a double summation of the series, and all of them are non-negative. So I can interchange the order of integration. So I can write this as summation over j equal to 1 to infinity summation over n belonging to integers of length I j intersection n to n plus 1, right? And now once again I use the fact that the interval I j, length of I j can be written as length of I j intersected with n to n plus 1 summation over n belonging to z. Just now we have proved that fact, the sigma finiteness of the length function. Any interval length I is summation length of its species inside n to n plus 1. So this is here. So that gives me the fact that, so this gives me length of I is equal to summation j equal to 1 to infinity, and this is length of I j. So that proves the countable additive property of the length function, namely if a interval I is written as a countable disjoint union of intervals. So this proves the countable additive property, that if a interval I is written as a countable disjoint union of intervals I n's, then length of I is equal to summation length of I n's. Whether I interval I is finite or infinite, that does not matter. So the length function is countably additive, that is what we have proved as an important property of the length function. Let us extend this property to coverings which are not necessarily disjoint. So that is called countable subadditivity. So that it says that if a interval I is such that I is contained in union of intervals I n's n equal to 1 to infinity, which may not be disjoint, then obviously we should expect that the length of I is less than or equal to summation length of I n's. And its proof is very much similar to the earlier case. So let us just go through the proof again, so that we understand how sigma finiteness of the length function is used. So I is an interval which is contained in union of I n's n equal to 1 to infinity. These intervals I n's may not be disjoint. Now what we do is look at length of I. I can write this is equal to sigma n belonging to z length of I intersection n to n plus 1, that is sigma finiteness of the length function. And now the interval I intersection n to n plus 1 is inside, because this I can write as union over I n's. So this is equal to, so let me write this is less than or equal to sigma length over n. So this thing is less than or equal to sigma length of I j intersection n n plus 1, j equal to 1 to infinity. So here what we have used the fact that the interval I to this intersection, this interval is covered by the union of these intervals. So and this is a finite interval, so length of this must be less than or equal to length of this. And now once again non-negative series of non-negative numbers I can interchange. So this is equal to sigma j equal to 1 to infinity sigma n integers length of I j intersection n to n plus 1. And that once again, this once again is nothing but the length of the interval I j by the fact that just now sigma finiteness of the length function. So, length of I is less than or equal to length of sigma length of I j's. So, this property is called countable subadditive property of the length function.